So, hi there, Mohamadu. Thanks very much for coming to talk to me today.
Thank you, Fiona. How are you today?
Yeah, I'm well, thank you.
Okay.
So perhaps we could start by if you introduce yourself and your role at the university.
Okay, my name is Mohamadu Dicko. I am an assistant lecturer of translation studies at Ghana Institute of Languages. Ghana Institute of Languages is a language center located in Accra, Ghana. We train translation studies at the undergraduate level in Ghana here.
Great. Super, thank you. And I know that you're using our Trados software as part of your teaching in your course. So perhaps you could just take us through a little bit how you're using the software and how it helps with your learning for your students.
Yeah, thank you very much. As a translation training center, we started using Trados a year ago, and we saw the need to really introduce it into our course, because a professional translator without translation technology or without a CAD tools, his work will be very difficult. So we saw the need to introduce it. But before then, we're not doing translation technology. We're only teaching them the traditional one, that is the theory and then the practice. So we started teaching translation technology, as I said, last year. So what we do is that we have a full year course. We have two semesters. So the first semester, we introduce them to translation technology. That is the history from the beginning of the translation technology, that is the machine translation, up to the modern trends of the technology. Then after the theory, we go to the practicals, that is the hand-on exercise. Here we introduce them to Trados Studio. So what we do is that we let them translate without having the Trados Studio. And then after that, we also let them translate using the Trados Studio. So now we tell them to compare the different ways of translating, the translation without the CAD tool and then translation with the CAD tool, for them to see the advantage of having the CAD tool and then the disadvantage of not having it. So when they see that, now we take them through, we start with the introducing them to translation of single file, one file. We use sometimes PDF file or Word file or PowerPoint or Excel file. Then we go to the project management. We teach them how to create their project using Trados Studio. So from the beginning to the end, and then creating project package also, how to send the project package, how to open it, and then how to return it. And after that, we also teach them the alignment tool. Trados has a tool that helps them to manage their translation work that they have already done. They can put it and then create a translation memory. So with that, it will help them to put all their translation together. And then we take them also through the translation, the theme base management. Trados has a special tool for that, that is multi-theme. So we also teach them how to use that. Before the introduction of the multi-theme, they were using Excel file for all their terminologies, which is not the best. So we introduce the multi-theme that is really very handy for them. And after that, we now show them the cloud-based. Trados Studio also has another tool that is very important, that is the cloud-based. With that one, you can have access to your work everywhere you are. Once you have the internet, you can move your work from the desktop to the cloud-based. So we also show them how to create a project on the cloud base, how to create translation memory, how to create the terminology, and then how to move their translation memory from the desktop, all the tools that they have on the desktop, how to move it to the cloud basis so that they can have access to it wherever they are without moving around with their computers. So basically that's what we do for the Trados Studio, yes.
That's great. Thanks, Mohamadu.
Yeah,
and how did you find getting set up with the software?
Yes, it is very easy to set up. We didn't really find it very challenging. But for a start, some of the students find it a bit. It has a lot of features that they find too complicated. But we, for a start, we limit them to translating of single files and then the project creation. So how to create your project and then how to create project package, how to send it and how to return it, and then how to translate, how to create translation memory and then the time basis. for with basically that is very easy for them, how to create their project also on the cloud, which is also very simple. The cloud portal is has less features than the studio. So yeah. Some of them also prefer using that because that is less cumbersome, as I can say, than the studio.
Yeah. So, yeah, when you're starting.
When you're starting, yeah. Yes.
Yeah, yes. Sure. Okay, yeah. Great. Thanks, Mohamadu.
You're welcome.
And so just finally, I just wanted to ask you what your thoughts are about the term translate everything, which is one of our goals now at RWS, and just to see what you think about that as a concept.
Yeah, I think that it is a concept that is very challenging. Translate everything. What do you understand by translate everything? For me, I see it from the point of view that what Trados is trying to do is to equip the translators, to give them all the tools that they have so that they can translate everything. If you have a tool that will enable you to manage your work in one place, that will help you put all your translation memory in one place, your term basis in one place, and then also including machine translation. Now, almost everybody is using machine translation, and then Trados has its own machine translation, that is Language Weaver. So if you have all this put together, you can translate everything you want. So that is what I understand by translate everything.
Okay, cool. Thank you. Well, hopefully the students of the future will be able to translate everything.
Yes.
Our future talent. Great. Okay. Thanks, Mohamadu. Thanks very much for taking a few minutes to have a chat with me today.
You're welcome. Yeah.